point above them in the table. And having looked at it, they've scored 30 goals, conceded 11, and with the Rovers scoring 36 and conceding 15, I think this is going to be a very, very close game.
Yeah, I think it's going to be very scrappy, and again, you're bang on with the points. And again, if we win this, and then we're in between Electric City that we have beaten, right? But I think Vaughan, again, they're their kryptonite. We have always kind of have a tough time with them and stuff like that. Very competitive match. So let's go Rovers. Let's hope we get those 3 points today.
Yeah, it'll be a big performance. Each player is going to have to step up and play at their very best for today,
sure.
To come away with the 3 points. But it's going to be a great spectacle. It's going to be two very evenly matched teams going head to head. It's going to be physical, but it's going to be a fantastic game.
Is there a player that's kind of that you're kind of looking at for this game? Kind of just shines for you or standing out for this particular game in particular, or?
Looking at the lineups and so forth, very, very good players on both teams. The one player for me who I think can continue and be a key player for the Rovers today is Javonte Lane. After scoring that fantastic goal in the previous game, confidence is going to be extremely high, and I think he's going to. I think he's going to be the main man for the Rovers today.
I think he's going to bring out his inner Drogba, you know, being a Chelsea guy himself, and he's got the Benzema tape, so we'll see what happens. Let's see if he can bring the two best both worlds
That's
together.
Let's go Rovers! And a fantastic turnout today as
beautiful.
Well. You know what, the JC Massey is rocking today. Great turnout. In the community for this game.
I think it's safe to say it's a fortress now. I mean, what do you think? You know, a nice home ground, great turnout. And again, Rovers are just kind of spearing, heading the attack right off the hop.
Yeah, straight away, nice direct ball, trying to look for Javonte Lane there. And already we're seeing Vaughan, they're very, very comfortable with the ball at their feet.
Now the big test is the defense from our end. I mean, yes, can we attack, but the question is, can we defend as well? So,
well, keeping a clean sheet in the last game is always going to bring confidence to the keeper and the defense.
Of course. And of course, Bajan, man, this is a guy that you want keep between the sticks. This is a strong, confident keeper that, you know, he reads the game so well. He calls everything out perfect, and he's that big, solid force you really want.
Yes, and very commanding as well. You know, constant communication with the team and the back four and keeping them organized. He's been a very good addition to the Rovers this season.
Agreed. Rovers getting that ball back for the attack. We're starting to see a quick pattern here that, you know, there's a lot of 1v1s in the wing, and Rovers recognize that. The Vaughan's a type of, you know, team that like to play on the wing, that like to attack on the wing, and it's good for Rovers to kind of recognizing that and trying to defuse the situation there.
Yes, and this is a very dangerous area for the Rovers. You know, we get the left foot on here, whip that ball across. Can they put it in the corridor of uncertainty? You know, in between the penalty spot and the 6-yard box.
Yeah, that sweet spot. Again, we see a little feed ball from the side wing there.
An excellent starting position there by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, I feel like he's always, like, you know, good chance of being 3 steps ahead, 4 steps ahead, and getting that ball out of there.
And we can see kind of from the get-go here, Rovers are playing a little bit more direct in this game.
Yeah, yeah.
So it'll be interesting to see how that's going to entail as the game goes on.
Yeah, we're kind of used to them seem just playing with the ball a little bit, kind of opening up spaces, but they know Vaughn's going to be a tough go, so I guess they're taking that kind of good risk in a way of just doing that direct kind of attacking play. We see Orlando Batiste there on the ground. And Orlandi, this is another player that kind of changes the dynamic. He's becoming more of like an attacking pit bull. Like he's there, he's attacking more, and the game doesn't break up so much when he loses the ball. So good on Rovers kind of working away with him.
Well, yeah, and he scored 11 goals this season.
Crazy.
You know,
crazy.
coming from midfield, that's a fantastic return in 12 games.
Yeah. With Orlandi's little chip over. We shot there with the Rovers! Right off! Right through the hop there. Our Rovers 1-0. Wasting no time.
And there it is. What a start for Rovers here at JC Massive Field. What a great finish that was. So with the ball coming over and then on the half volley, what a great finish right into the bottom corner.
And this is what we expect from Aja. Aja's the type of guy that when he sees the ball and he sniffs it out, he's there. He knows where to be at the right place at the right time. And what a goal.
And let's just take a moment to talk about the assist. What a ball just
beautiful.
Over the top there.
Beautiful.
Great start for the Rovers.
Again, Vaughn trying to snap back right away.
Trying to get that ball out of there. Yeah, they've got to stay switched on here.
Yeah.
You know, you're most vulnerable after you do score a goal.
Of course,
so
of course.
You know you've got to stay switched on here.
Yeah. Don't want to let your foot off the gas. You want to keep your A game 100% of the times, right? Just because you're, like you said, one goal up doesn't mean you're fully comfortable, right?
Yeah, 100%. You're right.
Portel trying to get this ball out of there, playing it from the back to the Capitan Earl. Portel finds George, tries to find Orlandi's.
The Rovers have made a very, very bright start to this game.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. This is just very organized, very like attacking method and stuff like that, but they're organized. They're not falling all over the place while they're doing the attack. It's working well with them.
Yeah, they look very, very composed on the ball. Moving the ball around now. You know, not playing as direct as they were. Now starting to keep the ball a little bit, looking to control.
Yeah, and they're including the goalkeeper, right? And, you know, Bajman again stepping a little forward and being part of that kind of that setup there. Tell Orlandi's a little unlucky there. Play on. And ref calling the play back. Aja. Portel. Portel trying to put that ball in for a main man with the shot. Deflection. Levante, he's hungry for that goal. He wants that goal.
And I love to see that by your striker there. You know, the ball's coming, first touch, he gets a half a yard, trying to get that shot off straight away. And that's what you want from your strikers.
Yeah. Yeah, he's definitely a defender's nightmare. You give him that little inch of space, then he's gone, right?
100%.
Yeah.
Great half a yard, and then pull the trigger.
Yeah. Ball in there. goal over there. That's it. We have a second. Right off the woodwork, right there. Our boys aren't giving anything away. 2-0 in the first half, 8 minutes in.
And they have come flying out the traps today, the Simcoe Rovers. Here we go. We're going to have a little look here at the goal. So the ball comes out nice and wide. What a great ball in, great delivery. Wizard of a left foot. And then the ball has just fallen right there. And Poacher's goal. Love it.
Having someone like De Silva, a fullback that can header the ball, can be rough and dirty into the box, and set up a goal like that is a dream, is a coach's dream.
And the Rovers, they wouldn't have wished for a better start than this. What a fantastic start to the game. 10 minutes in, 2-0 up.
Yeah, it's definitely crazy, and it's something that we didn't expect, you know, from Vaughan. This is a team that, again, we've always kind of had a tough time with. We're always kind of worried of, you know, when we play them, but today it looks totally opposite. We look confident, we look good, and, you know, hopefully we can bang in more goals.
This is where, though, the Rovers, they can't let any complacency sneak into their game. They've got to keep focused, keep pressing, keep doing what they're doing, keep doing the simple things right.
Again, we're seeing these Rovers not giving Vaughan any inch of space, you know, setting up these offside traps perfectly and actually just, you know, taking control of the game.
Yeah, and that comes down to great organization by the captain Earl at the back there, telling the boys when they have to step up, keeping in line, keeping organized, keeping it structured.
I think this organization period has right found the great captains from even the boys and the women's team. I mean, kudos to both captains. They know how to, you know, command their team squad. They're great leaders, and kudos to them. So we're trying to get that ball off.
Good to see that by the Rovers pressing as a unit.
Yeah, they always find a way to help each other out. If someone needs help on the flank or the back, they always kind of push back and kind of fill each other's gaps and stuff like that. So they are definitely working well as a unit. Silva.
Rovers boxing in Vaughan here, making it very, very difficult for him to play out.
Yeah, no, for sure. They're doing well, covering all these choke points, you know, for Vaughan, and it just works out. You can tell, you know, the Vaughan are struggling, they're getting a little frustrated, and Simcoe, they're just keeping their cool. And again, quick little 1-2s as you can see from Lawson and De Silva. Again, we see, you know, attacking players like Benitez coming back, and they have to defend, they will defend. Hey. Juan trying to make something out of this. And deflection from our very own Cameron De Silva. Or I like to say Mr. Sergio Ramos, his favorite player. Lawson. Javante. And then we see Vaughn just forced. They're literally forced just to dump the ball down the field. They can't even do any short passes because, you know, their teammates are getting, you know, really well man marked. It's good to see from Rovers.
Yeah, that was it. That was a good ball over the top, but once again the organization fired a defense there to set that offside trap there.
Yeah. And Vaughn forced to start over from the back.
So you can see here with the Roses, it's not a full press. They're letting Vaughn keep the ball around at the back, and then when this ball comes in now, you'll see the press from the Rovers to win it back when it's coming into just past the halfway into the final third.
Yeah, it's amazing to see. They know when exactly when to press.
And that comes from hard work on the training ground.
Oh, for sure. It's definitely.
But this is a very, very dangerous area here. The Rovers need to be switched on for this dangerous free kick coming in.
You see Bajman taking the orders, stepping up and telling these guys where to position themselves. And he's been spot on pretty much every game. He knows where these players need to be at all times.
That's a fantastic ball in there by Vaughn. Yeah. If we look here, nice little whip on it.
Yep. Silva right and over. Javi George.
Once again, the Rovers there looking more direct.
Yeah, they're very pushing hard. They want to get as many goals as they can against this Vaughn side.
Play. Omar, open up. Omar.
Swan now are starting to find their feet a little bit. They're starting to be a little bit more comfortable with the ball and now starting to cause a few issues with the Rovers.
Yeah, I think this is the time where, you know, even since the first minute, I think Rovers need to kind of, don't let that happen for Vaughan. Don't let them get that confidence. Don't let them get that comfortable with the ball and start pressing forward with. Because that's when, you know, problems start to happen, right? If you give them too much space.
Yeah, they're really starting to grow into the game now. They're starting to move that ball a lot quicker and moving it with confidence.
Benitez trying to get that ball. Great work from Benitez. And again, we got Lawson. Arjen Robin Lawson trying to cut in there. Again, they're pressing hard into deep into their half. See in the replay here. Player come flying in, the Rovers luckily didn't result in a card. Gotta give credit to the gaffer. He molded these group of young lads together so well, and he kind of fixed on their weaknesses and just used their strengths as well together, and they're very well organized, and they know how to communicate. So very kudos to the gaffer here.
And yeah, I mean, he's done a fantastic job, because with a big turnover, lots and lots of changes, you know, to get that team to gel. And like I said at the beginning of the game, it seems now that it is starting to click. That cohesion between the team is now starting to gel.
For sure. Starting to see a sense of, you know, aggressiveness right now with both of the sides. A little scrappiness energy going on.
Yeah, the referee's going to have to keep an eye on this. I don't think it's going to be long until we see the first yellow.
Yeah. Yeah, the ref's going to be busy tonight, that's for sure. You see Lawante down. Could this be serious? Up, shaking it off. Let's hope it's nothing serious.
Yeah, just a little bit of a collision. One of them 50-50 battles.
Yeah.
This is something certainly the Rovers have been working on. It is part of the game plan to play more direct football. We've seen numerous times that ball is going long instead of playing short and playing out from the back, because they know that they're going to get that press there from the ball, so they're just going to have to start looking to play long.
Yeah, and I think this is definitely something that, you know, the gaffer has really kind of focused on during training. He knows Vaughan's kind of play, so he kind of pressed that into the minds of these young lads. Like, hey, listen, we got to change up our game plan for these guys, and fantastic job so far.
And here we go again. We're gonna see this ball whipped in with that left foot into this danger area here. So Vaughan needs to be switched on.
Ooh.
Just needed a little bit more pace on that ball.
No, definitely for sure. Already getting to that aggressive battle right now, Rovers. Again, they're just picking away, not giving up. Just throwing their bodies on the line for the ball, not letting any balls coming near Bajman. Exchange between the two. I mean, the fall was a little questionable if you ask our opinions, but a little heated.
Well, what did I say? I told you it wasn't gonna be long until we see the first card.
Yeah. We have the both sides trying to calm down their players.
Yeah, it's becoming very, very heated on the field at the moment, and this is just going to continue as the game goes on. Yeah, you can see the tension is high between the two teams.
Yep.
And this is what happens when you're playing your rivals. You're playing a derby.
Yeah,
right.
For sure.
The tempers are going to be high. You know, there's a lot riding on the game.
Yeah.
And you know, Vaughan, they probably weren't expecting to be 2-0 down in the first 25 minutes of the game.
Yeah, no, for sure. And it's not easy for them, too. I mean, coming away, they're going to kind of a fortress now. We've developed kind of a fortress here at Massey Field, and, you know, they have to deal with the away fans plus the players, so it's not easy. It's all of a mental game now, right, as well.
So I'm struggling to see who he has sent off here.
I believe Vaughan had one red, and I believe we had a yellow, but I could be wrong. It's very hard to see.
But it looks like Elijah is leaving the field.
Yeah, I love it. Elijah is leaving the field as well. This does hurt us. I mean, Vaughan did lose a player as well. Yeah, so both players do lose a player.
Well, the referee is going to have his hands full this evening.
Looks like he's going to run out of cards soon. And I think Rovers now, they have to take this as a lesson and just kind of work with it. It is a hindrance on our part.
Has
been given to number 9 for Vaughan Azuri, Omar Mazouk. And for Mystical County Rovers, number 18, Ija Haley, has been given a red card. So 3 from Vaughan has stayed on, and Ija has received the red card.
Come on, dribble there!
So now with the Rovers playing a man light now down to 10 men, they're going to have to be very focused. And we're going to see now again, the tactics are going to have to change. They're going to go into more of a defensive shape.
Yeah, this is going to be the real test now. I mean, this again, this is a lesson that we have to kind of learn from. And when it comes to tensions these high, we have to kind of learn to keep down our emotions. And let's see. I'm curious to see what the gaffer is going to do now.
So we can see here Vaughan now playing with a little bit more urgency.
Yeah, they see a little window of opportunity, so they're going to try everything they can. They're going to throw everything at them, kitchen sink included. That Vaughan are kind of regaining that confidence now, especially double confidence now with us getting that red card. Let's just see this shot coming out there. Good effort.
Yeah, got creates that half a yard for himself to then find that space to pull the trigger.
See Orlandi's anything from here. Now can our guys come up with anything flooding the box right now? Oh, nice delivery there.
Yeah, one thing about Orlandis is he does have a fantastic delivery.
Oh, 100%. Yeah, he knows how to deliver those balls in the box.
And it looks like Orlandis has now moved out to the right wing. He was playing as the shadow striker, but now it looks like he's going to be moving out to the right wing. So that could be dangerous for the left back, you know, because with him cutting in on his left foot.
Yep.
You don't want to give him too much space near the goal.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, Latin Fever Benitez, he knows how to cut in great. He knows his timing is impeccable when it comes to that cutting in, and his finish is just unbelievable. So, yeah, I mean, he's every, you know, left back, full back's, you know, worst nightmare. Again, Vaughan just trying to cut across to see if they can make anything happen in the middle. Chris,
we'll now start to see the Rovers are going to try and keep the ball.
And we see on the road Benitez. Get him in with Benitez! Benitez! Orlandi's Latin Fever! Benitez!
And what a goal by Orlandis! I was saying before, you know, with him now shifting out onto the right side of the field, that cutting in on his left foot. He's got a wizard of a left foot, and we can see it here when he comes in. Just across the keeper. What a finish.
Unbelievable. You called it. You called it.
And JC Massifield is bouncing. Who would have thought it? Coming in near half time.
3-0.
3-0 up.
Crazy. Definitely. What a goal that was. That was just a fantastic goal. And again, we see the crowd going in. I mean, they couldn't be off. Obviously, the red card kind of hinders a little bit, but we just kept going, kept, you know, hammering away.
Yeah, we'll take one more quick look at it here. Just knowing that his stronger foot, just to switch it on there with the right foot to his left foot, and then the finish was top class, just across the keeper. Unbelievable goal.
Celebration was cold. He just kind of, you know, celebration, just, you know, the nice cherry on the top, right? It was very good. And Vaughn bring one back. Ladies and gentlemen, it is going to be a scrappy one tonight. You can tell.
And there we go. That was the goal that Vaughn were looking for. So it's a ball just over the top. Great first touch. And then a nice finish underneath the Russian keeper. And that was it. Like I said, the Rovers, they can't let the complacency set in. You know, even being 3-0 up, all it takes is one goal. And now the confidence for Vaughn being back in the game.
Yeah, I mean, it, from a pinhole, it could turn into a tear, right? So let's just hope that, you know, we don't concede two more goals or three more goals, and we just got to keep the momentum going.
And I did mention it before, you are most vulnerable after you do score. And it wasn't long until Vaughn then get the ball forward and then do score. But now the same for Vaughn here. They've got to stay switched on because Rovers will be looking to try and kill this game. Come on!
Ooh. Again, we see with this ref with the cards. His arm's going to be sore by the end of tonight. Giving away these cards.
He's going to have a very, very busy evening.
Yes. As you see here, the ball being delivered. It's the collision between the two players. Again, Orlandi's, like you said before, that delivery on that ball is just so lethal. Again, ooh, delivery there. Can he get to it? What a delivery from Benitez, though.
Yeah, absolute great ball in again. And then Javonte Lane getting up, and the ricochet when it comes off a defender just didn't fall kindly for him.
A little bit of a battle with Lawson here. Back with De Silva. Vaughn trying to split up that midfield. See Benitez running down. Ooh, a little collision there. Game on, says the ref.
That was a fantastic challenge.
Yeah.
Great tackle.
Yeah. Again, Vaughn trying to make something out of this. With the play.
Yeah, it's going to be back to the wall job here for the Rovers. You know, Vaughn are going to be pushing and pushing and pushing to get back into this game.
Yeah, they're definitely not going to give up. This is a team that, regardless of the score line, they're going to keep going. They're going to keep pushing.
Fans, since you're becoming a referee, Ontario Soccer wants to hear from you. Please visit ontariosoccer.net/recruitment for more details.
Being super aggressive on that play. He's hungry for that goal. Bajan just knew there was an opportunity, so he took it, came out just to recover that ball. He didn't want to take any chances. Benitez trying to get that ball there. Portel playing it back to De Silva. Lawson to De Silva. De Silva trying to meet Levante.
Yeah, Javonte Lane's going to be a little bit isolated up top now. So he is being played as more of a target man at this moment with them direct balls coming in. But what is happening. He hasn't got the support, so when he is receiving that ball, there is no support for him to then play it off to.
Yeah, that's where it makes it difficult. Again, Vaughn's just forced to play a little bit outside now, trying to hit that restart.
The fourth official has indicated there will be a minimum of three additional minutes.
Yeah, they're just trying to shift the Rovers here from left to right. Trying to find a little bit of space in behind.
Yeah. An additional 3 minutes, that is a dangerous amount of time. Anything could happen in 3 minutes. So hopefully, you know, we don't come into the second half 3-2.
Yellow card has been issued to the goalie number one, Todd Conn, at the 90th, 45th minute.
A little aerial duel between Lawson and Vaughn.
Yeah, it's very important here for the Rovers to stay switched on. Going in at 3-1 at halftime will be a fantastic achievement, saying that they are down to 10 men.
Yeah, and we're starting to see the kind of the frustration raising on the Vaughn side. And so hopefully, you know, Rovers can capitalize on that and just kind of make it a nightmare for, you know, Vaughn.
And this is a great opportunity here now for Vaughn from the corner kick to try and pull goal back right before halftime.
Yeah, this is very important for Rovers to get this ball out of there. And Lawson picking up that ball. Javier George. The keeper sending the ball out for a corner.
And it can change that quick. Now the Rovers with an absolute fantastic opportunity to try and, you know, get another free goal cushion and take it to 4-1.
Yeah, minutes like 3 minutes and up. It's anything could happen. May play it short. Lawson trying to find Benitez. This is the ball on the plate. Vaughn trying to see what they can do in the last bits of this first half.
Great stand position there from the goalkeeper.
Lawson down.
Up shot.
See what Desilva can do with this ball. As a fullback, he knows how to deliver this ball good as well. See if you can find anybody on the other side.
And there we go. What a great first half there for the Rovers. Now going in 3-1 up, but hindering there with going down to 10 men. So it's going to be interesting to see how Rovers respond to that in the second half.
Very good to see, though. I mean, the positive side of it is 3-1. They come with guns, you know, blazing. And again, let's hope they don't make any mistakes and kind of cost them. You know, the red card is a hinder side for us, but I believe that we can pull through if we kind of keep everything together.
Yeah, it's gonna be very, very interesting to see how it goes. They've got to stay focused. And we'll stay tuned for the second half.
Greg, my name means everything.
Tom Longboats.
I am Wolf Clan, Onondaga Nation. I've run many different races. I've run to survive and to be free. I've run to win for honor.
His people might be lazy, but this one's damn fast.
My people respected our runners, people who carried important messages from village to village.
I need a guide to the next post.
Dispatch carrier, sir. I can get you there.
God sakes, man, slow down. Who do you think I am, Tom Longboat?
No, sir. I am.
Running makes me feel alive. It's everything.
Tom Longboat was the first indigenous person to win the Boston Marathon. He ran his way to international fame and became an inspiration to generations of athletes.
Welcome back to JC Massey Field. We are here with the Rovers 3-1 up against Vaughan. They have gone down to 10 men, so it is going to be interesting to see how the Rovers will play in the second half, being a man down. So I am going to pass you over. I am going to introduce Fernando, who is going to have a little chat with President Julian de Guzman.
Hello, everyone. We have the main man himself, Julian de Guzman, Mr. President himself. How are we doing today?
Great, man. Great, great. Exciting times.
Can we talk about the game for a second? What a scrappy, scrappy game. We did not expect this from our Kryptonite team of Vaughan. But what did you think of the game so far?
Listen, I think it was full of excitement. We wanted goals. We got the goals in the first half, 4 goals, and I think in favor of the Rovers, the boys have been putting in a really solid performance against a very strong, you know, team that has proven themselves. Vaughan have played at the top level already, and I think there's a lot to prove in this match.
Yeah. Can we talk about the red card for a second? I mean, do you think the Vaughan could have, you know, not to be so biased, but you think Vaughan could have got that card as well too, or?
Yeah, I mean, I thought it could have gone both ways. You know, certainly both players were out of line. The refs got a better view than I did, that's for sure. But at the end of it, I mean, the decision has been made and we're going to have to make the best of it.
Okay, final prediction of the score tonight. What do we think? More goals? More goals?
I think there's going to be more goals for sure. I think the Rovers still have a goal in the locker. So hopefully we can get that fourth one. If we get that fourth one, it's a matter of us playing smart. But hopefully we don't let Vaughn back in the game. If Vaughn get a goal, then we're in danger. So hopefully the Rovers win 4-2.
Perfect. You heard it here, folks. 4-2 from the president himself. My man, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Rovers, we're out.
To get paid for your work.
There are rumors freedom's coming for us all.
Freedom, you know that's all I want.
Chloe, careful. Vroomen would rather sell you across the river to America than let you go free.
Then I'll run.
I've run before. Maybe this time for good.
No! No! Just get her into the boat. No!
Chloe Cooley's resistance led to Canada's first legislation limiting slavery. After 200 years, slavery was abolished in Canada in 1834.
Yeah.
guys, back to the second half, and man, oh man, what a game we have so far. Simcoe County Rovers 3, Vanazuti 1, and we start off the game guns blazing as two goals into the game, and then that unfortunate red card from the Rovers and come back with the third goal. But Vaughn, surprisingly, came back with that one goal, so let's hope that our guys just stay put with the three goals or more and don't let Azuti grab any goals from us. I think it's something that we need to take part of the second half going in. I think we need to be just keep that aggressive momentum going. And I think we need to keep Vaughn as isolated as we can. Yes, it's only 3-1, but I feel like, you know, if we kind of keep our feet off the gas pedal a little bit, Vaughn will take advantage. But all in all, I got to give our guys props and kudos. They've been very strong, very confident behind the ball. Let's hope we can score more goals. I mean, if I was the coach right now, I'd kind of play like a Jose Mourinho kind of approach, park the bus and hope for the best and maybe squeeze in one on goal, but I would definitely kind of, you know, be careful and kind of play the safe end for this, especially against Vaughn. Definitely play the safe route and park the bus. Yeah, no, definitely with this red card, it affects, you know, both sides. I mean, now Vaughn kind of have that advantage. They've got that kind of confidence. And with us, it kind of knocks our confidence, right? And let's hope we don't concede any more red cards. That's when we get into deeper trouble. And that kind of gives a strain to the gaffer and with, you know, formations and moving guys around. So luckily we kind of can adapt to that. But again, that's something that we don't want to concede anymore is that red card.
Georgia community, the Canadian Blue House. Near North Customs, Westland Insurance, Heineken, Trainer's Choice, Sparks Medicine and Rehabilitation, Mind to Muscle, Dominion Lending Center, Gas Free Wall Mortgages, Church and Chevrolet, Soccer Home, Rogers Team Services, Owl Group of Companies, Pros Marketing, 107.5, Cool FM, Rock 95, Berry 360, and Aria, Alex Pressure Studios, and the Canadian Soccer Sentinel. We'd also like to acknowledge the following league partners. CIBC, the leading partner for Soccer Canada, the Canadian Premier League, and League One. Gatorade, rehydrate, replenish, refuel. Degree, inspiring confidence to move. MacLeod, work hard, play harder. Vibrant Performance, Canada's most trusted brand for automotive race parts and accessories. Sports Engine, bring your team together with Sports Engine HQ. The Canadian Premier League, where Canadian soccer takes flight. Ontario Soccer, encouraging us all to play, inspire, and unite. And Canada Soccer, sign up for the new Canada Red Fan Membership Program to get the inside track on national team tickets, exclusive merchandise, and other promotions.
Strength and guidance, all that I'm wishing for my friends. Nobody makes it from my ends. I had to bust up in silence. You know you gotta stick by me. Soon as you see the text replying, yeah, I don't wanna spend time fighting. We got no time and that's why I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time but I go. How the powers take a hold on me. I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time but I go. How the powers take a hold on me.
Yeah.
in the second half, Swan and Zuriat making two substitutions. First coming in, number 23, Marcel.
Harry Jake, what a game. What do you think? I mean, did not expect the scoreline. Very entertaining, very scrappy game, but craziness. What do you think?
Yeah, I was very, very impressed with how the Rovers came out the trap so quick, you know, and going up. They looked really up for it, but now we're going down to 10 men. It's going to be a big, big second half performance because we know Vaughan are going to be up for this now. They know that there's a slight opportunity. And if they get an early goal here in the second half, it's going to be wide open.
Yeah, aside from the Vaughan goal, I mean, that red card was pretty much the highlight of the game. It's a big blow for us because now the gaffer is going to have to switch everything around. And it did kind of help us in a sense because we ended up getting that third goal, but still, red card's a red card. So we're going to have to make sure that everything's going on all cylinders and all fronts.
Yeah, they've dropped to a 4-4-1, which is now leaving Lane very, very isolated up top.
All right, Rovers fans, it's time to kick off the second half. Time to make some noise for your Central County Rovers.
And I think that's a sacrifice that the gaffer's willing to take at this point.
Let's go, Rovers!
Yeah, he's gonna have it drilled into the boys here to, one, you know, keep the concentration. You know, don't let the emotions get over. You know, it's a heated game, it's a derby, it's rivals. So he's gonna talk to him, and he's gonna talk about being disciplined, you know, when out of possession.
Yeah, most definitely. See now, Vaughan trying to open up some space here, starting down the wing. Feed the ball in there. Oh, a little bit of an effort there from Vaughan.
Yeah, straight away you can see Vaughan are coming out of the traps. They're looking to try and get an early goal here, and then put the Rovers on the ropes.
Oh, a little bit of delivery there. Offside. I think we missed a memo tonight for the hand tape. Everyone's got the hand tape going on. But it's looking good for the squad. I mean, again, it's the team just needs to kind of stay in pace. We see that back line kind of forming up really tight.
And again, the Rovers defense keeping the line there. Playing that offside trap.
Yeah, they definitely know how to spring that trap pretty good. Really on the ball with that.
But once again here, we're going to see the ball go long.
Levante trying to make something out of that.
Yeah, especially with Lane up there as a target man kind of thing. It's, you can see it is part of it to play long and see if he can feed off any scraps there.
Yeah, no, definitely for sure. Try to make something out of here. We'll turn around from Vaughan. And De Silva getting that ball out of there.
Yeah, it's going to be some back-to-wall defending here for the Rovers. Going to have to put the body on the line.
Yeah, definitely a big difference from the first half.
And you can see 3 minutes in already, and it's all been Vaughn.
Yeah, it's definitely, yeah.
All right, Rovers fans, I want to hear those thunder sticks nice and loud.
As we can see here, with a thunderous shot over there from 17 of Vaughn. What an effort. And a little dangerous there from the back. Again, a little scrappy there.
Yeah, it's a big part of the game now, you know. Keepers have to be really, really good and confident with the ball at the feet, you know, and you'll see that playing out from the back. Excellent defending there.
Very good.
Stood him up, stopped the cross from coming in.
Yeah, very good. Against another test from the Rovers. Can they defend this corner? Can they kind of flood in that box? And again, I think that's another weakness that we're kind of seeing in the Rovers, that, you know, they're defending so much in the box, but they always leave that outside man, you know, waiting for that shot. So I think that they're going to recognize that and kind of just switch up the play a little bit and make sure they have someone marking that the guy on top.
Yeah, it's going to be a fascinating second half to see how the Rovers are going to change their tactics throughout.
Earl. Wajman quickly getting rid of that ball. Again, we're seeing Vaughn trying to open up that space, and then right away, Rovers make that conversion. George. King with George.
I think he's very lucky to escape not getting a yellow card there.
Yeah, we see a gaffer getting upset with that. That should have been a yellow. Again, see if we can try it from the wing there. Benitez in his strongest suit. A little bit of a scrappy battle there.
Yeah, he's done very, very well there to win that free kick in a dangerous area. You can see the Rovers are being extremely cautious on now. You know, both centre-backs staying back. In the first half, they were going up for 30s.
Let's go, Rovers!
Yeah, usually we see centre-backs kind of advance a little bit, but they don't want to take any chances.
Thank you.
exchange of words between Vaughn and the ref. They don't look too pleased. Another fresh face for Vaughn.
Number 13, Joe Mack, and he'll be substituting for 14, Sammy Kaduka.
And a good delivery is needed here.
Nice venomous shot from Benitez. Here we go there. Little punch from the keep. And no choice to do that.
To play with a little bit more urgency here now. Yeah. Raise the tempo, play a little bit quicker.
Even though it's a little early in the second half, anything could still happen, right? And now this is where Rovers need to, you know, they need to make that switch.
Header from Da Silva out of the box. And that's a great switch of play there by Vaughn, but absolutely excellent 1v1 defending.
Portal, that was very beautiful from. Nothing comes out of that.
Yeah, you could see the idea, just a little bit too much on it.
But kudos to Rovers. I mean, they've got that when they have those open pockets of space, they're quickly ready to fill in those voids really quickly. And it doesn't matter if it's a defender, midfielder like Portal, it's just they know how to do it and they'll fill those voids real nice.
A little bit of football there to win the corner for the Rovers.
Anything there?
And that was a fantastic delivery there. But it does look like there was a free kick given to Vaughn. But the keeper's done well there, you know.
Yeah, keeper is, yes.
A point blank save. Great reactions from the keeper as it comes in. and to Pam away from the danger.
Unlucky there from Vaughn. There was a little bit more power, then things would have been a little bit more different. George Benitez. Slip and go there. Vaughn trying to attack from the wing. And again, just excellent kind of defending play from Rovers, giving Vaughn no chance of breathing space whatsoever.
Yeah, Earl did recover well. He did step out there to win the ball, and then had to recover and get back in time.
I do like how Bertel's kind of playing a little more deeper now. Helps back the defense if he needs to, which is good to see. George trying to find Devontae here. Devontae, a bit of a collision there.
Yeah, it's going to be very, very difficult for Lane this second half. He's going to be feeding off scraps, to be honest. He's going to have to work hard and try and make his own look better to try and get something on target.
As you can see here in the replay, a little bit of a collision there, nothing too serious.
Bonner is making a substitution. Coming into the game is number 15, Isaac Bradbury, and he will be replacing Christian Cecchieri.
Great recovery from Benitez. Tell George. Benitez, a little Cuban connection here. And the left wing kind of exposed. Vaughn trying to take advantage.
Yeah, and that's the thing, you know, when the Rovers are trying to push forward here, they are leaving themselves a little bit open and vulnerable.
Great defensive play from Rovers. Seeing a little bit of tight space, you know, duels right now. A yellow is given out now to Vaughn. Seeing the replay here.
Yellow card to Bonnesbury number 23,
yep. Marcel. Well done there, bye. Bybatch coming out, closing that space nice and quickly, making the striker there have to make the decision nice and quick.
A little few words exchanged from Bajman and the referee.
Come on, Rover fans, let's hear some noise.
See what Rovers can do in the defensive end on this left wing. Again, the other Cuban connection between Portel and Benitez working very well.
Yeah, great tracking back there by Orlandis. Helping out his partner.
Connection there.
And looks like we'll see another yellow card coming out here.
Again, we said it now, we're going to say it again. The ref will be busy tonight.
Very busy. He's going to have a sore arm tomorrow, that's for sure.
As you see here.
As you can see, ladies just knocked it in there past. Using his pace, trying to get across.
A little bit of some leg lock action there, so. Benitez do with his delivery.
Once again, very, very dangerous area with this left foot, swinging it in. Can he put it on the keeper? And the keeper does well to claim there comfortably.
Again, Vaughn on that wing, trying to run up the middle. Beautiful defensive play from the Rovers. Again, laying their bodies on the line.
Yeah, incredible last-ditch defending there by the Rovers. But it is that they're going to have to work extremely hard, throwing the bodies on the line here to protect this lead.
Yep.
But you can see Vaughn are really starting to turn the screw here.
Yeah, they're trying to throw everything they can to at least get that goal and two goals. But I feel like they want more than just a point. They want that win.
Thank you. And the referee has given a penalty here for Vaughan. Big opportunity. Let's have a quick look here. So the ball coming in, little touch, and it just looks like a little bit of a lazy left leg, just catching the ankles there. So this is a critical moment in the game. 20 minutes to go. If Vaughan can get a goal back here, 20 minutes to go with one goal deficit. And it's a very good penalty, nice and calm, and right down the centre there for Vaughan to get back in 3-2.
Now this is the test, this is the ultimate test now. Can the Rovers hold out for 30 minutes? As you can see in the replay here.
Yeah, this is going to be a big, big test here now for the Rovers, you know, mentally and physically, you know, to keep in the game here.
And Bob's going to be making a substitution coming into the game.
But this is a thing, you know. Cards change games.
Yeah, they do.
You know, it's one of them. It's changed the way the game was going.
Yeah.
You know, it's now going to be a very, very tough test for the Rovers to see if they can come away with the 3 points.
Yeah. I got to give kudos to Vaughan, though. I mean, they're not giving up. They're pushing hard. I mean, coming back from a 3-1 deficit, and again, it's not a matter of they want the 1 point. It's the matter of they want the 3 points. They want to take all the marbles, so. See Bajman down. See the replay of a nick there. Clip there. Again, we're looking at the game as more as the time approaches, more scrappy this game is becoming.
Yeah, with so much riding on this game now with the clock. We're approaching the tail end of the game. It is starting to get a little bit heated again, as both teams know what's at stake here.
There, good effort from Ravon, but nothing comes of it.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see now as we are coming into the tail end of the game, the fatigue setting in. You know, the Rovers have had to work a lot harder, you know, being a man down.
Yeah.
So it's going to be interesting to see how they are going to react with the last 10 minutes or 15 minutes coming up.
Yeah, they have to pull that extra weight definitely to fill in that void. So let's hope that, you know, fatigue, like you said, doesn't, you know, let them be their enemy.
And that also comes now down to game management, you know, by the Rovers.
Of course. Again, the gaffer's going to have to, you know, do those tweaks, those changes, you know, to fill in that gap, to fill in that void.
And as you can see, it's all warm right now.
Yeah.
It's going to be a long 15 minutes or so here now for the Rovers.
Yeah. Time's going to go very slow. Little exchange of words with Vaughn and the technical staff. Players sneaking in a couple stretches.
Hopefully that magic sponge is going to work its wonders here.
Yeah. Vaughn, see what they can do.
At the 37th minute, Vaughn is ready to making a substitution. Coming into the game, it's number 7, Abdurrauf Rahim of Mohammed, and he's going to be replacing number 11, Ryan Robinson.
Bash, man, he's ripping that ball into play. Oh, and Vaughn take advantage of that, trying to capitalize.
Yeah, they're obviously going to get back in here now, find that shape.
Again, Rovers trying to form that back wall, letting nothing in. Effort from Vaughn.
And you know what, the Rovers, they'll want that. They'll want that all day, shots from distance.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, going in for the last 10 minutes or so here.
Yeah.
You know, there's going to be lots and lots of balls into the box.
Yeah.
But they'll take shots from distance
all
day.
Yeah, they'll take those wide shots, those long distance shots. And it's a dream for Bajman. If he can handle those all day, then it's a cakewalk.
Inside, inside, inside more.
And again, dangerous ball in by Vaughan. Really looking and pushing for that equaliser here as we enter the last 10 minutes or so.
Let's see if our boys can get this ball out.
As you can see there, Vaughan have absolutely crowded the box. Only one player back for Vaughan.
Yeah, it's a risk they're willing to take. They want that goal, so if they need to flood that box, leave that one player out there, they'll do it.
And this is what you're going to see now. You're going to see them. They're going to start putting more bodies forward. Yep. And that's an opportunity here, hopefully, for the Rovers to counter.
Yeah. No, that's a penalty. That's a penalty.
And a penalty here for the Rovers for an opportunity to make it 4-2. Absolutely fantastic to take it down the wing and then coming across to get across up the body there of a defender. And a little bit of a pull trip, which gives the Rovers a great opportunity here to make it 4-2.
And who will be taking it? Could be our captain, Il Capitano, Earl. Could be Latin Fever, Benitez. But looks like Il Capitano's going to take it. Kind of a little Matarazzi kind of moment here.
And a big moment here for Earl.
Can he execute? Oh! Can he make the rebound? Good effort from Vaughan.
And it's a fantastic save there by the keeper. He's given his team the opportunity to give them some more life here as we go into the last 10 minutes. What a big opportunity here for the Rovers. But they were unable to take it there. Fantastic save by the keeper.
Yeah,
you know, got strong hands on it. Yeah. Great save.
Yeah. I mean, you being a keeper yourself, we talked about the last game with the girls. I mean, his positioning was par. He read the kick very well, and he executed. So that was very good from Vaughan.
Yeah, very, very well done to the keeper there. And he's given his team, you know, a bit of a lift here now. You know, it's the last few minutes as we're coming in that's going to give them confidence here.
Yeah, most
you
definitely.
Know, if that goal's in, the 4-2, 10 minutes to go, you know, kind of the confidence gets drained a little bit from the team.
Yeah. Yeah.
But now he's giving them a big lift here to go out.
Yeah.
And now can they try and find that equaliser?
Yeah, most definitely. As you can see in the replay right away, Keep just knew he read that kick very well.
It was a good height for the keeper with Earl looking to go low. But the keeper did extremely well to read where the shot was going.
It's a very big test now for Rovers in the 82nd minute. And I can only imagine the additional time that we're going to get added on now with a lot of the stoppages. So that could be another hinder for the Rovers.
That's the Rovers, man. Keep up that energy.
Oh, yes. That's going to be. There'll be some added time.
Another card.
Yellow card given to number 9, Yvonne Lynn, at the 83rd minute.
Love a mixed up card there, as we can see. Now Rovers do need to watch out with these cards. Some of these cards are on their first yellow, so.
Yeah, that's the last thing the Rovers want, is to go down to nine men. You know, this is where they need to keep their discipline as we go into the final minutes here of the game.
Yeah. And Vaughan's going to use his advantage now. They're going to try to kind of see where, if they can get away with a few things, you know, get Rovers to pick up any yellows or stuff like that.
And this is an extremely dangerous area here.
Very
now.
Very dangerous. They really need to flood the box in this opportunity right now. Make sure this ball does not go between the sticks.
And the wall doing its job there.
Good job on the wall. Right now, Vaughn trying to cut into the box. See an opportunity again using that left wing.
That looks like a soft penalty for me. The ball's come in here, it's come up, it's off the leg, and just hit the arm. The arm's down by his side there. I think that's extremely harsh.
Yeah, very harsh.
And a very, very tough moment, you know, for the Rovers here. Yeah. They've had two penalties here now against him.
Yeah.
But it comes down to, you know, the penalty miss for the Rovers.
Yeah, no, definitely for sure. It's kind of like my quick reaction, muscle memory and stuff like that, and I think that's not what the ref is taking into consideration. And again, like you said, it's very harsh. Can Bajman read this right this time? No! And the post has saved us.
And it
the post has saved us.
It's hit the crossbar. And they haven't been able to take the chance here to tie up the game.
If I was Bajman right now, I'd be kissing that crossbar.
What a moment. Here we go. As if we look, he's going for the top corner. And he's put a little bit too much on it.
Deja vu from World Cup 2006. France versus Italy. Trezeguet missing that. As we can see again.
And yeah, nowhere near going over the line. Vaughan were looking, celebrating, thinking that it had gone over. Well, this game hasn't disappointed, that's for sure.
Very much of a blockbuster match. The penalties, the cards, the goals.
And this is why we love the sport, right?
Again, we see the Cuban connection, and it falls off with George.
Substitution for Vaughan coming into the game, number 10, Geronimo Sabato. He will be replacing number 13, Joe Mack. And it's going to be interesting to see how much added time is going to be added on here. You know, it's been a very entertaining game.
Yeah. Vaughan putting in some fresh feet. Will that make a difference?
And this is what I was talking about before, about the game management by the Rovers, you know, looking to take it to the corner flag and now winning the corner from it. which is great to eat up a little bit more of the clock, you know, take it to the corner.
And that's the thing, Rovers can recover from that. They do that quick 1-2 and they know how to adapt.
Yeah, they will take their time here just to try and eat the seconds. Again, winning the corner there just by holding it into the in the corner, eating up those seconds as we are approaching the 90th minute, and it is going to be interesting to see how much added time we will get here. Now this is what can be dangerous here now, is when Vaughan can counter
again with that wing, could be very dangerous. And this is where things started to heat up. Things to get a little more scrappier and scrappier. Let's see if we have a card here. Another yellow. Again, can they draw that ball in? Can a deflection? And again, Rovers, an amazing job throwing their body on the line by Il Capitano himself. And again, a beautiful defensive play from Earl.
And that is fantastic defending. Throwing his body, he's just saved a goal there, you know. And 6 minutes of added time.
Unbelievable. 6 minutes. And we go.
And now can they counter? Just not enough weight on it. But now they've got to get back in, get the shape. They've got to manage this game well.
Seeing the replay, a little bit of a back clothesline there from Vaughan. It's again physical.
Yeah, heat again, but you know, he's bringing his arm up there. I'm surprised that a yellow card wasn't shown there.
Make sure that he stays seated.
And the thing is here now, there's just going to be more time added for this stoppage here.
I gotta say though, this game hasn't disappointed at all in one bit.
No, it's been a fantastic game to watch, and I mean the crowd have been treated to an absolute spectacle here, you know. Yeah. You can see Vaughan are overloading up top here. Looks like they're playing with five strikers, it seems.
Yeah, anything for that goal. Good defensive play from Rovers, getting it out. Avante, can you get it over? Oh, is there anything there? Is there anything there?
And this will be a red card.
This has to be a red. A yellow.
I'm surprised.
Wow.
Last man, the keeper
wow.
there.
Wow.
I'm surprised the red hasn't been shown there. Linus knocked the ball past the keeper. The keeper there has now taken out the striker. The last man. I'm surprised the red card has not been given here.
Very confused at this moment.
Here we go, Lane working extremely hard, and you see it's the trying to knock, and it's a red card for me all day.
Kind of a Juventus theme going on right here, especially with that yellow, but it is what it is. Again, see if you can make the difference within the 2 minutes here. Again, very physical game. Again, Vaughan trying to capitalize this counterattack.
Well read by Earl there, stepping out to win the ball.
Again, very scrappy, very tough on this wing.
And that's just what the Rovers won there. More time to eat up the clock.
Gonna barge mine, see what we can do with this ball, just lay it down the line there. Benitez trying to fight off that ball. Rovers trying to take advantage. Benitez. Outside the box here.
Fantastic little bit of skill there by Benitez. Nice little step over, drawing in the defender there to win the free kick for his team. Now it's going to be interesting to see what they do there.
And this is somewhere where Benitez excels. He can score, you know, free kicks from this kind of angle, from this summit distance. We've seen it a few times here this season. So Vaughan are very nervous setting up that wall. Benitez fires the shot. Whoa! Great effort from the keeper.
And again, a big save. Great free kick there by Benitez. And the keeper's done well to come across here. But here we now taking it to the corner. Wasting as much time as they can, waiting for that final whistle here.
Can Vaughan do anything with this in the last seconds of the game? Can they make something out of this? We see the fans urging the ref to blow that whistle. And that is it, folks. Wow, wow, wee, wow. 3-2 Rovers. What an amazing game.
And what a game, like you said. A huge, huge 3 points for the Rovers.
And again, this is a game against a squad that, again, we've mentioned before, is our kryptonite. And we managed to sneak in for those 3 points.
And that game, it had absolutely everything. 5 goals, red card, 2 missed penalties. There should have been probably another red card as well in there. But what an absolute fantastic game. And a huge, huge 3 points for the Simcoe County Rovers.
And that is it, folks. Thank you so much for joining us here tonight. 3-2 Simcoe Rovers against Vanizzuti. Good night, guys.
First goal is critical.